So good morning. It's December 5th, and this is the greeting card season. I'm Janine Bolin, and this is the Saturday training that you guys have come to know and love. As you know, I'm a very linear type of person when it comes to business. I'm highly creative, but I'm highly structured at the same time. And people are like, how can that coexist? I said, I don't know. It's a 24/7 job. I do it. You're right. This is how we do. So what I wanted to make sure is that you're ready to send. Most of the people that have been with me for any period of time know the very first thing I'm going to talk about is, do you have the app downloaded to every single device that you own, so that when you get that prompting, you're not having to seek your phone. If you're already on your tablet, you can do it. If you're already on your laptop, you can do it. If you're already on your desktop, make sure every electronic device that you own has the Send Out Card app. The next thing is that Send Out Cards has started asking you to verify your account with your cell phone number. This is based on stuff that they have coming up, not only with a better way, but also it allows them to be able to communicate with you and assist with the SOC Pro app. There's many reasons why they're asking you for your cell phone number, and it's also that you can have more ease when it comes to growing your business. Step two. What we need to make sure of is that you are on the plan that is most suited for you. What I say to people who are business owners, okay, so please remember this caveat. If you're a business owner and you are using Send Out Cards as a way to send out holiday greetings to everyone in your CSV file, then I recommend you drop down to the $17 a month plan and buy a system package and go from there. And then in January, crank back up to the $97 a month plan and all that. But that is just something that when people start budgeting, I always say budget $500 for December for your marketing plan. And then I walk them through how to set up their Send Out Card system. If you are one of our affiliates who's just come on board in November because of a better way and you had somebody reach out to you, I highly recommend that you start on the $37 a month plan. This gives you 30 heartfelt cards for free. And I'm going to talk to you about how you use that very effectively for yourself as you build your usage of Send Out Cards. After a month, I recommend for my people, after 1 month of using the card a day plan and working with me, that they immediately go to the $97 a month plan, because you join our Power Hour and you will be using that very effectively. It will be worth your time. The system package is here. You can click on a big button here that says purchase package. It'll ask you what plan a month you want to use, and make sure to talk to your people. If you have people signing on, remind them about the expense bucket so that their Visa or their MasterCard isn't getting continually pinged with 55-cent charges or whatever. Also let them know this is the account, and it will let them know how many system sends they have remaining. So a lot of people get a little nervous about how many cards do I have left on this package, and here you go. So step two, all right? So that was all step one. Step two, work on your business. I don't care if you're a business owner or whatever, Send Out Cards needs some time, and this is how you're going to work on your business. You're going to take an hour a week to do each one of these things. If you are in business for yourself, you understand this. You know how important it is to do an hour a week of prospecting, an hour a week of follow-up, an hour a week of connecting, and an hour a week of training. This is required. So I want you to break out your calendar after today's training, after you listen to this, break out your calendar. And I don't care if it's digital or if you're still using a paper calendar, it doesn't matter to me. And I want you to start setting times. An hour a week for prospecting, follow-up, connecting, and training yourself. All of this is quite important. Spend an hour a week moving your addresses out of your paper folder, your contacts, whatever, and spend that hour a week doing nothing but moving addresses over into your relationship manager for Send Out Cards. Most of my people know that that's what I use the $37 a month plan for, is that I ask you, ask your people for their address, send a card, put it in the relationship manager, and move on and build your system very organically. That way you're constantly getting into the habit of moving your system around. Step three, this is basic building, business building 101. I've been running businesses since the age of 10, and I'm currently 56. So I've run 15 different businesses. I made it a habit to sell them off and then make it the next business. And so this is stuff that I know, and this is information that I know will be very helpful for those of you who may have never run a business before. And that is, in most MLMs, they ask you to start talking to people who you already know. Okay. Well, a lot of people that you already know are pretty leery of MLMs. You start mentioning MLMs and building a team, and they will give you all kinds of excuses. So what we do in Send Out Cards is very different. We're very different. And this is what I love. It reminds me of the old Mary Kay way of doing things. And I love Mary Kay. Okay. So I'm going to just say that right now. And that is, who do you already know? And what you're going to do is you're going to go through every single contact that you have in your phone or in your contact base or however you keep track of people. And you're going to call them up and say, hey, I would like to have your address so I can send you a holiday card. December is the perfect month for this. Everybody understands the holidays. They want to receive a card from you. I actually had somebody who isn't in Send Out Cards say, hey, I would like your address. And I said, oh, why? And they said, I want to send you a holiday card. I'm like, oh my gosh, are you with Send Out Cards? And they went, no, I'm doing them all by hand. I went, oh my gosh, you are joking. She became an affiliate. Okay, moving on. So what I wanted to share with you is you have all of these areas to reference. You have Facebook, you have LinkedIn, and you have the contacts on your phone. What I want you to do is list off how many people you have in all of those areas. These are all people you know. These are all people that are already in your field. And I want you to start taking them out of the digital world and putting them in three-dimensional world. Again, I use the same graphic because we want to pull them off your tablet and electronic media. We want to be in the three-dimensional world, building our relationship with them. How do you do that? Through what we call a master contact list. Now, all of you are on my class or my course here today. I actually have this lesson. I actually have a Google Doc built for you. So when you get, hey, the recording is now available, I'll have a link in that email that will send you directly to that specific lesson. When you have that document, I want you to make a copy of it in Google Docs so that you're not overwriting my document, but take that document, make a copy of it, create that file, and I want you to build your own master contact list. Now, you're welcome to use Google Docs. You can download it and make it into a Microsoft Excel spreadsheet, or if you're a Mac user, use your numbers. I don't care. The thing is, start building this sucker now, okay? Now, if you're like, Janine, I don't know how to download my contacts from Facebook, LinkedIn, I don't know how to do all this, YouTube is your friend, right? I mean, if we haven't learned anything else in 2020, we have learned, oh, hail YouTube and all the people who have posted videos showing us how to do everything from taking care of why our dryer is working but not heating versus how we go about taking care of the mold in our shower. Or is that just me? Okay, so the other how-to videos are on my website at JanineBoland.com/how-do-I. Just smash all that together. And I have YouTube videos that either I have created or other people have created, and I've listed them off on that sheet. And it will tell you how you go about building your contact sheet. Your activity, your mission, if you choose to accept it, is your job over the next several weeks, all the way through January, is ask people for their address, add them to your relationship manager, send them a card. I don't care if it's January 18th. Have you ever heard of anyone complain because you were late in a holiday card? Never, never. I've never had anybody complain about my card, except they're not getting enough of them. Now, I have heard that one, okay? So just to let you know how powerful the 4-hour a week system is that I've been training you on today, when I first started with Send Out Cards, I only had in my contact database 285 addresses. This is when I really got serious because I ended up with a team that I wasn't expecting. I always wanted to just do Send Out Cards for myself and my business. I never wanted a team. So I only had 285 clients that I had in my CSV file March 2020. And I promised you that as I was teaching you and training you, I would always update you every week on where I am. Currently, I'm at 538 addresses. I've almost doubled in just 8 short months. This is insane, okay? being able to get this many addresses in this short a period of time when I am already a full-time business owner. I spend, you know, 50 hours a week on my quote, quote, real job. And I only spend 4 hours a week on my send out card job. Okay. So that just lets you know what you can do with 4 hours a week. This is an increase of 253 people. I have moved them off the digital media. We are now in a warm relationship where they are receiving cards from me. This is 31 new addresses a month. Basically, an address a day is what my average is. So what are your next steps? Well, here you go. For those of you who like to-do lists and like to check off things, download the app to every electronic device. Schedule your 4 hours a week that are your critical 4 hours to grow your business. Download all your contacts into a massive CSV file, which means comma separated value. It just means spreadsheet. And start calling those people and asking them for their address. It's all incredibly simple. But the key here is, when should I do this? The answer is now. And my slide deck decided to go nuts. Just a second. And the answer is now. And next week, I will ask you guys, how much are you increasing? Figure out what your baseline is. How many addresses do you have in your relationship manager right now? And then brag about how many people you added next week. Please, this is what we celebrate here, okay? Another place you can go for additional support on the 4 hour a week system is my website, JeaneBoland.com/videos. And that's where I actually walk through the 4 hours a week. Now I had somebody say, well, Jeanine, you talk about the 4 hour a week system, you talk about prospecting, but you don't talk about anything else in those videos. I went, yeah, because people aren't doing the basics yet. When you all achieve the basics, then we'll move on follow-up. But right now, get that master CSV going, okay? There you go. So this is Jeanine Boland with Saturday Training. And now I'm going to bring on my guest, which is Nancy Zare, who I have to share with you. The Metro group on Facebook does the Send Out Card Power Hour, where they spend an hour, 5 days a week, sending cards. I totally took their system, and Nancy is here. She's the one that invited me to this system. And we're now going to have her talk to us about building cards with style. So Nancy, if you take it away.
Great. Well, thank you so much, Jeanine. For those of you who don't know me very well, I am a psychologist, and I use my knowledge of psychology to help you with sales conversations. And I want to thank you, Jeanine, very much for allowing me and giving me this opportunity to talk about something I enjoy and am very excited about. Our agenda is to talk about the fact that there are four different ways people make buying decisions. I'll give you some characteristics, but of course, our focus will be on cards that you can send, because I'm a big believer in Jeanine's system, especially in following up. Cards are an excellent way to follow up. They get a 100% open rate. Have you ever noticed that people are different? Of course you've noticed that people are different. They actually speak different languages, even when they're speaking English. And it turns out that those languages I'm going to refer to as styles, and I label them number 2, number 4, number 6, and number 8. And that's based upon the number of contacts or touch points that each of those styles needs in order to be able to go forward and say yes to an opportunity. So I'm going to start with these characteristics of these four styles. The number 2, they're a red hot style, they're fast acting. They only need 1 or 2 contacts in order for them to say yes. In fact, just 1. And characteristic action, they are in massive action. You recognize them because they've got a Bluetooth in their ear, they're, you know, driving, texting, you know, chewing gum, doing it all at once. They love attention. They love to be the center and take center stage. They like to have fun and party, and they like the red carpet VIP treatment. So can you think of people in your life who are like that? Here are some cards for the number 2 style. Congratulations, by the way, all these cards are from Send Out Cards. You can find them right in the catalog. Why did I choose this for the number 2? Because the bold colors, because they want to be congratulated. They want to be acknowledged. Again, that attention. Hey, go ahead and toot your own horn. Well, this is exactly what the number two is all about. They will let you know that they are, you know, the cat's meow. They want to have fun. So yeah, they definitely something that's fun. And by the way, a big selfie goes a long way. And this is the person that actually, if you send that oversized card, they will love it. They love to get lavished with attention. And I chose this particular holiday card from our selection because, again, it's merry and bright, which is what they are all about. Right in your face, want to get your attention, and want to be acknowledged as special. Moving on to the number four. This is a style that takes 2 to 3 touch points plus one. The plus one, when you add it to 2 or 3, is about 4 touch points. They're very fast decision maker, but not as fast as our number two. And that plus one is important because they get cold feet, buyer's remorse. This is the person that within 24 hours, there needs to be one additional contact to let them know that you care about them personally. You see, they're all about a personal relationship, connecting heart to heart and connecting in an authentic way. They like things that are real, genuine, down to earth. They are casual, comfortable, let it all hang out type people. They don't stand on ceremony, very giving, very generous. And it's all about family and about kids and pets and, you know, relationships. They love motivation. So hence, this is going to be a hint in terms of the cards you select. So what kinds of cards do we want for the number four person? We want cards that are moving forward. It was fantastic spending time with you. Again, they want that relationship and they want to be acknowledged that we have a connection and a bond. Also, the flowers are very important for someone like this because they like flowers and they like nature and they like sunshine. You know, best friends forever. Who could say it better? I mean, this is, again, the person who wants that bond with you. They want a connection. They want to feel that you care about them as a person. And if you, of course, in this case, this is a photo card, it would be great to put themselves, you know, them and you on a card. Here is Dare to be Great. It's a message from Marianne Williamson. As I told you, they like motivational messages. They like, you know, that kind of positive, upbeat kind of feeling. I am the worst. Oh, this is an apology card, but again, the flowers, you know, and the fact that you're being genuine and authentic and talking about a mistake you may have made. I chose this particular seasonal card because, again, of the floral design and because of the message. As you go dashing through the busy holiday season, take time to appreciate the true blessings of Christmas, the moments with family, the companionship of friends, and the fellowship with all. This is exactly the message for a number four buyer. Okay, number six. This is the person who's very orderly, methodical, wants everything, all the ducks in a row. They want things, you know, in a sequence, step by step, and it should be neat and clean and tidy. They tend to be fairly reserved and mannerly, very courteous people. They, you know, the gushiness is for the number of four. This is the person who's, you know, stiff upper lip, kind of, you know, keeps everything kind of close to the vest. They're neat and organized, you know, super polished. They always look like they have just out of the dry cleaners, no matter what time of day. They're very traditional. They like brand name things. They're not out of the box. Things that are safe, conservative, traditional. So what kind of cards would be for the number six? Again, very tasteful, not a lot of colors. It's not bold. It was very nice to meet you. Just understated simplicity. It's back to school time. The ducks in a row. It's very neat. You know, everybody's following in order. This would appeal to the number six. Welcome to the neighborhood. Yeah, it should be this courteous, you know, a card that welcomes them. That would be just in good taste. And anything patriotic, you know, anything again that feels very, you know, write, celebrate the holidays for sure. I chose this card because, again, it's just a moderate in colors. It's not over the top. It's very simple. You know, happy holiday to you and yours. And again, that just says it very easily. Well, the last buyer is this number 8 educated style. You know, they are a deep thinker. They, you know, do a lot of research. They have to get all the information they can about something. They prize intellect. They tend to be smart people, but they absolutely like people who are intelligent, bright, competent, well-read, etc. They spotlight ideas. For them, it's the contents of the mind that's important. You know, what is going on in your head? They have a very dry sense of humor. They like to play on words, and they like, you know, that kind of a double entendre, things that might mean two things at once. No fluff, no frills, no hype. You know, leave that to the number 2. They want over the top, and the number 4 wants all that gushy enthusiasm. No, this person is doesn't like that at all. So what kind of cards would be for that very thoughtful, educated, you know, buyer? Well, here's one. The difference between the impossible and the possible lies in a man's determination. This is a quote from Tommy Lasorda. And again, determination. This sounds like a good card for that number 8. Again, we hold these truths to be self-evident. Yeah, again, a quote from the Constitution, because they're bright, they're heady, they're intellectual. Love is like a tree. It grows of its own accord. It puts down deep roots into our whole being. Again, a quotation. Notice that the cards I've also selected are very, you know, the colors aren't in your face. It's just kind of subdued and moderate. Luck is not found but made by those who are determined, and you're one such person. They don't like a lot of praise or attention or recognition, but that's kind of on the mild side. And again, the colors are very, you know, it's kind of monotone here. I chose this particular holiday card because, again, it's subtle. You have to kind of fill in the lines. So it requires a certain intellectual amount that they have to put into the card. And it's not over the top. The colors are subdued, and a very tasteful message inside. Just Merry Christmas, Happy New Year, you know, Happy solstice, whatever. So just to summarize, yes, there are 4 different buying styles, and there are, each one has different values and characteristics. I have a book, Compelling Selling, that gives you all this information, plus ways to identify those 4 different buying styles and the exact words to use that will connect quickly and authentically with each style. And of course, how to follow up, including cards. If you're interested in this book, which contains, by the way, a reference to videos about following up using cards, you can order the book, again, an autographed copy from me on rapportbuilders.com/book. And the end of Rapport Builders, notice it ends in a Z, not in an S. And that's for my last name, Zare. So, people speak a different language. One size does not fit all. You need to select a card that is right for them. And that is my little presentation on cards with style. I'll stop my share. You're muted, Janine.
I'm getting there. Thank you so much, dear. You had your card up very quickly. Do you mind verbally stating your phone number?
Oh, the phone number is 508-981-2315.
And you are welcome to contact Nancy either as the psychologist that she's absolutely fabulous at, or you can contact her as a fellow businesswoman or a send out card user or as an author. So she has a lot going on, like many of us, and so feel free to help her out. I am going to stop the recording now. We're going to open it up for Q&A.